Dear children of God, sisters and brothers in the Lord, greetings to all of you through this YouTube ministry, Jesus Today Ministry. We wish you all a very happy month of February in 2020. This brief meditation comes to you for the month of February 2020, along with Mr. Dr. James Rajasekaran, who is organizing this YouTube ministry every month. I greet you all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. When we were thinking about this brief meditation for the month of February 2020, we thought of talking to you on the theme Lent, because we are beginning the season of Lent in the month of February this year, on the 26th of February, which is going to be the Ash Wednesday. And when we think about Lent, the word Lent itself is a very important word. Lent comes from an English word which has the root for lengthening. Therefore, Lent means to lengthen, to grow. That is why we say in Tamil, Lent means valarchi adaidal, to grow in spirituality. I have 3 points again to tell you this time as well. What are all the 3 things that we are expected to be growing in this period of Lent? First of all, let us grow in grace of God, in the grace of God. The Greek word for grace is charis. The grace of God is a great, great experience, both in the Old Testament and in the New Testament. God is gracious, and that is the very important thing which is spoken in Psalm number 103, the greatness of the grace of God. It is so large, it is so deep, and it is so high. And I would like to tell you that God's grace is greater than your sins. God's grace is greater than our sins. Forgiving grace. Therefore, in this Lenten season, let us experience the grace of God, which forgives our sins, which is called the amazing grace. Cross is the symbol of grace. Secondly, let me tell you one more thing. The second thing, we are expected to be growing in fellowship during Lent. Fellowship. The Greek word for fellowship is koinonia. Koinonia. Let us grow in fellowship in the family. There are broken families. There are so much of hurdles in the families. Let us try to grow in fellowship in the family. Let us grow in koinonia in the church. And also, let us grow in koinonia in the community. In the community. Whatever is possible to bring fellowship in the community. We live in a divided world. We live in a divided community. As Christians, as God-fearing people, let us try to bring koinonia in the community. Koinonia also could mean oneness. The oneness which we see in Acts of the Apostles, 2nd chapter and 4th chapter. Reconciliation is a great thing in the experience of koinonia. Let us strive for reconciliation both in the family and in the church and in the community. Let us encourage others to grow in koinonia. And finally, thirdly, I would like to bring another word. Let us grow in giving. Let us grow in giving or sharing. The Greek word for giving is didomi. Luke very interestingly uses dia didomi, which means sharing. Sharing with the needy. Sharing with the afflicted people. And that is the thing that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ was demanding us as the perfect thing. If you want to be perfect, go, sell your goods and give to the poor so that you may have treasure in heaven. The same thing comes in Mark 10:21. The Lord demands us to live simply as much as possible during the time of Lent. The time of Lent is a time to practice simplicity. You may know that great statement. Try to live simply so that others could simply live. So I would like to request to grow in sharing in the term of Lent. Let me bring all the 3 points again. To conclude, we grow in the time of Lent. First of all, to grow in the grace of God. Secondly, to grow in fellowship with each other. Thirdly, to grow in giving or sharing with the needy. Finally, a little humor for you. There was a Christian family. They were praying before the time of Lent, a family prayer. And the mother told the little girl, "We are thinking of giving up certain things during Lent." Lent means to give up certain things. And she asked the little girl, "What would you like to give up?" The little girl said, after some thinking, she said, "I would like to give up the Sunday school." And the mother said, No, that is not the thing that I am asking. Think about something else to give up." And the little girl said, "Then I would like to give up the church." Dear friends, it is a wrong kind of understanding of Lent. Let us have a right understanding of Lent. To grow in grace, to grow in koinonia, and to grow in giving. Amen.